हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ द नेक्स्ट पोइम इज द सॉलिटरी रीपर विच इज रिटन बाय विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ हु वाज़ द रोमांटिक पोइट. द रोमांटिक पीरियड स्टार्ट इन 1798 विद द पब्लिकेशन ऑफ लिरिकल बैलेट्स. दिस इज अ कंबाइंड वर्क ऑफ विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ एंड हिज फ्रेंड एस टी कॉलरिज. बोथ आर रोमांटिक्स. The romantic period starts with the publication of the book Lyrical Ballads in 1798 to 1834. This is called the romantic period. William Wordsworth is the giant figure of this age, and on the second number, S. T. Coleridge. There are two other fellows are also P. B. Shelley and John Keats. These all four guys are the major poet of this age. The poetry of romantic age turned to the nature, return to nature, return to the native lands, return to the countryside. Because in neoclassical age, the poetry is written to relate to the god, relate to the sublime themes, but Wordsworth and Coleridge turned it to the nature. P.B. Shelley is a poet of revolution, and Keats is a poet of human beauty. But Wordsworth relates to the natural poetry, or we can say the poet of nature is Wordsworth. S.T. Coleridge writes for the sublime themes, and he used the huge words and high diction. He said a simple story in the high words. But Wordsworth's style is just opposite. He said the big themes in some simple words. The poem Solitary Reaper is belonged to a girl who is alone in the field and reaping his grain and singing a song. Wordsworth cannot imagine the theme of the song. So he said that, I don't know what is the theme of the poem, but the music of the tone of the poem is very sweet to the ear, and he remembered the song many, many years. He was born in 1770 and died in 1850. This is the period of Romantic Age also, in 1798 to 1834. He was made Poet Laureate in 1834. Poet Laureate is, we can say, in other words, the national poet of England. The Solitary Reaper. Behold our single in the field. William Wordsworth starts the poem with these words. Behold her single in the field, yon solitary highland lass. Lass word is used for the girl. The subject is very familiar, seen from daily life. We see that in countryside, many women and men goes to work in the field. They cut the grain and they bind the grain. It is a common scenery in the countryside. And the scene is also familiar, because this scene can be seen everywhere in the village side. And subject is also very familiar, because Wordsworth writes many natural poems, has wrote many natural poems. This poem is related to Romantic Age. Wordsworth once went to meet a friend with his sister and his friend S.T. Coleridge on Highland side. Highland is referred to as Scotland. He goes from valley to valley. Suddenly they heard a song from a long distance. They went near and saw a girl was reaping the grain and singing a song. Which tune seemed them very sad. The tone is very sad. She was reaping and singing by herself. Suddenly, Wordsworth changed his tone and said that, stop here or gently pass, because he didn't want to disturb the girl. He said that, stop here to listen the song of the girl, or gently pass if you don't like the song. Alone she cuts and binds the grain. She is reaping and she is binding alone in the field, and sing a melancholy strain. Melancholic strain means a sad song related to a bad feelings or the bad memories of the past. Oh, listen for the wail profound. The sound of the girl make full to the whole valley, and the sound of the girl profound, and it makes a resounding echo sound is overflowing with the sound. No nightingale did ever chant and more welcome notes to weary band of traveler in some shady haunt among Arabian sand. No nightingale ever chant. The nightingale, which is known to welcome in the weary bands, to the weary bands in a desert side, never sings more sweet than this girl. Never sing. Of travelers in the some shady haunt among Arabian sand. Arabia is a country of desert, which in the center of the desert, it is said that there is a nightingale who was sitting on a branch of the tree and welcome to the weary bands or weary groups, tired groups of the travelers, and show him his sweet voice. In springtime, from the cuckoo bird breaking the silence of the seas among the furthest Hebrides. Now, poet compares the voice of the girl with the voice of nightingale and voice of cuckoo. He said that both the birds are sweeter, but the voice of the girl is more sweeter than the voice of the nightingale and the cuckoo bird. Will no one tell me what she sings? These lines show that he does not know what the girl is singing. The theme is unknown to him, and the language is also very peculiar to him. Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old, unhappy, far-off things and battle long ago. He just guesses that the theme of the poem, the theme of the song of the girl, may be some sad feelings of the past. Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old, unhappy feelings of the past, or for battle stories, or it is some more humble, lay, familiar matter of today. Here, Wordsworth make a humor that the subject of the song may be a familiar matter. Some natural sorrow, loss, or pain that has been and may be again. It is another theme of the poem can be that it can be a natural sorrow, loss, or pain of the past time that has been and may be again. It has this time, it is exists this time, and may be again to the girl. Whatever the theme, the poet said that he don't care about the theme because he loved the sweetness of the music and the echoism of the song. The maiden's song, as if her song could have no ending, because the tone of the song, the sweetness of the song is echoed in not only in the valleys, but also in his heart also after many days or many years, this incident. I saw her singing at her work and over the sickle bending. She was bending over his sickle and just continue cutting his grain and binding the grain and just singing once again and again the same song. I listened motionless and still, and as I mounted up the hill and the music in my heart I bore long after it was heard no more. The Wordsworth, his sister and his friend pass the highland or pass the Scotland, but after many days of this incident or after many years of this incident, the words and the tone of this song echoed in his heart. So we can say Wordsworth loved the natural scenery, the nature, the mountains, the valley, the solitary girl, or we can say countryside girl. These are the very familiar, or these are the very repeated subjects of Wordsworth's poetry. He loves to the nature very much, as we see in his poem, To Daffodils, which was also one of his most beautiful poems. To Daffodils is dedicated to a flower which is yellow in color and was found in the Lake District side, and we see that he also was born in the Lake District of Northern England. Wordsworth, Coleridge and Southey, these are called lake poet because they all born near the river or the neck or the lake. Wordsworth is belong to the romantic age. Technique of this poem is very effective because there is an effective rhyme scheme. The first line fill, but then the less herself and pass and grain, strain, pound, profound and sound. Each two lines are rhyming with the other lines. The second line rhyme with the third line. Second line rhyme with the fourth line. Third line rhymes with the fifth line and sixth line. And the seventh line is rhymed with the eighth line. This is a rhyme scheme continuously in each stanza. So we can say the rhyme scheme of this poem is very effective. The first line rhyme with the third and the second to the fourth. This is the description. The technique of the Wordsworth is very easy. He uses easy diction, easy words, because he wants that each reader can enjoy his poem. And he wants that the common man can enjoy his poem, because he writes about the common man, he writes about the countryside people, the common people, solitary park, we can say the farmers, flowers, nature, fountains and mountains. The technique is very familiar to us. The poet come across this young girl reaping and singing aloud as she walks. Now we can summarize the poem. When poet went to a countryside to meet one of his friend, he was with his sister and the sister Dorothy Wordsworth and a friend S.T. Coleridge. They went to Scotland to meet a friend, and there they heard a sweet loud voice who fill the valley with his profound voice, the echo voice, and the sweetness remains after many years in the heart of Wordsworth. He invites us to see her, and she cuts and ties the sleeves of the grain together, singing a sad song. The subject of the song, it seems very sad because the tone is very sad. It may be a fight scene, it may be a familiar matter, it may be any other painful experience of the girl, but she continuously singing his song. There is no stoppage between the lines. There are only three works she is doing. One, she is cutting the grain, and she is binding the grain, and third is she is singing a song which has no themes. Wordsworth asks many times that, can somebody tell me what is the theme of the song of the girl? But there is no one who can hear him, because he was only thinking in his mind, and they are going to meet a friend. He advised to the reader, behold her or gently pass. Look at her and listen to the music, listen to the song of the girl, or you should go very gently, because you have no right to disturb the girl. This scene is a natural scene or a countryside scene which is loved by Wordsworth. Wordsworth is called the greatest worshipper of the nature. His most of poems and works are centered to the poetry of countryside and the poetry of common men. The poet finds her song so melodious that he feels that cannot be comparison with the nightingale or with the cuckoo bird. These two comparisons are given by Wordsworth. He said that a cuckoo bird or a nightingale, both are called the most sweet voiced birds, but they cannot be compared with the girl, because the song of the girl is more sweeter than these two birds. As nightingale welcomed many persons in the center of the Arabian sands, and the cuckoo which welcomes the springtime. Cuckoo's singing welcomes the springtime, and the nightingale welcomes to the weary bands of the travelers. Both are known as very sweeter voice, but the voice of the girl is more sweeter than these two birds. Shakespeare used hyperbole here, because he loves the music of the girl's song, and he enjoyed the music and the tone after many days and many years and many months of this song. As we saw, William Wordsworth write many poems on nature. He never write the poem on the spot. He saw the girl, and after many months, he just remember the scene, and then he fell in it, and then he composed the poem. He feels the beauty, and he feels the sweetness of the music after many days. So we can say the theme of the poem is very natural and countryside theme, and he uses the natural sources as the solitary lass, the field, the mountainside, the valley, and the girl, and his unknown-themed song. All these make a very sensible poetry of Wordsworth. Wordsworth uses a universal theme in this poem, because we see that the farmers are everywhere all around the world. Whether or one is understand the language or not, it is not is the theme of this poem. If we want to enjoy a song, it is not needy to know the theme of the poem or the theme of the song, because the tone can make merry us. Similarly, William Wordsworth enjoyed the poem, although he don't know what is the theme of the poem. He suggests many themes, but he said that I don't know what is the theme. He suggests that it may be a battlefield theme, it may be a familiar matter, it may be a pain of the girl, or which is now and may come in the future again. He don't know what is the theme, but he enjoyed the song very much. The haunting music is impressed upon the poet's mind and lingers in his memory even after it cannot be heard any longer. He heard this song many days ago, but until now he enjoys the music and the tone of the song because he loved the music of the song. Now, I want to summarize the poem. In first stanza, poet saw a girl in Highland side, which is can be said the Scotland side. Scotland is in the upper part of England. It is a very natural site, and there are mountains and valleys in this area. And he said that the yon solitary girl is reaping and singing, reaping, binding, and singing a song in the field area alone. There is no one in his company, in her company. Wordsworth and his sister enjoy the song, which profound, which fill the valley of that area. And the song is sung in a loud voice. The poet suggests us to stop there or go peacefully, because he wants that no one should disturb the girl in his working of singing and graining or binding the grain. No nightingale did ever chant. This shows the hyperbole, the use of hyperbole and the use of his metaphors. He compares the nightingale and cuckoo bird to the song of the girl. He said that the girl's song is more sweeter than these two birds. And in the last, he discussed about the theme of the poem, which is not known by the poet. He said that he does not know what is the theme of the poem, but this is no matter, because he can enjoy the tone as well as if he knows the theme. So this is the poem written by William Wordsworth. Now, the next poem is Above Ben Adhem's poem, Above Ben Adhem, which is written by Leigh Hunt. Leigh Hunt is a very famous English poet who was born in 1784 and he died in 1859. Leigh Hunt take a character from Bible. So we can say that this is a biblical character who is known as the Above Ben Adhem. Above Ben Adhem's story is very popular in Bible. Above Ben Adhem is a very religious person who prays for God and work for the poor persons, and he does work for the common man or the poor man or the needy persons. And he is called the most important worshipper of the God. Now look at the poem. Above Ben Adhem, may his tribe increase. Tribe means his children prospers many, many years after his death. Awoke one night from a deep dream of peace. He suddenly awoke one night and saw there was an angel in his room. He was with his yellow light and with the holy book. And the angel was busy in writing something in his holy book. Above Ben Adhem, who awake suddenly, asked him that what are you writing in your holy book? The angel said that I am writing the names of the person who love the God too much or who are the lover of the God too much. Abou Ben Adam curiously asked that, is there my name also in it? Or there is a place anywhere that he can be found in the book? The angel disappointedly said, no, there is no line for you. There is no space for you because it is a book of those person who loved God very much. Then Abou Ben Adam appealed to the angel. Now, we can imagine what appeal he can give to the angel. But he said that he can write his name, the name of Abou Ben Adam, in the list of the person who loved his fellow persons, who loved the poor person, who loved the sociality and the social persons and the needy persons. Angel disappeared at that time. Abou Ben Adam understand nothing and sleep again. In the next night, the angel reappeared and Abou Ben Adam suddenly awoke once again. He saw that angel was busy in writing today also some names. He asked, what was your disappearing of the last day? What is the meaning of disappearing of last day? What did you want yesterday? The angel said nothing and showed him the book. He shows him the book and there is the name of Abou Ben Adam at the top of the book, at the top of the list. This list is the same list which was shown yesterday to the Abou Ben Adam. This is the same list in which the angel is writing the name of the person who loves God very much. Now, today, the name of Abou Ben Adam is in the top of the list. This story shows us that we should love our fellow men and the God loves us firstly. God sent us on this earth to love our fellow person, because if we cannot love our neighbor, how can we love to the God? Because we saw the neighbor every day, and if we cannot love a person who is our neighbor, whom we see daily, how can we love to God whom we never can see? So this is a question on which Leigh Hunt wrote this poem. Abou Ben Adam, who was a biblical character, gives us a moral statement that if you love your fellow person, you love to God. If you want to love to God, love to your fellow person. The poem shows how love of our fellow man is ever greater than love of God. The poem shows how the love of our fellow man is greater than love of God. If we love to our fellow man, it is greater to if we love to the God. God also accepts this. God said that I made the man to love his fellow person, to love his fellow man. If we love each other, there is no need of God in all around the universe. And the angel wrote the name of Abou Ben Adam at the top of the list, the persons who loved God very much. Abou Ben Adam loved his fellow man, and this is the very much liked by the God. The angel was listing the names of those who loved God. When he first appeared, the angel was busy in listing the name of those who loved God. Ben Adam's name was not in that book. He said to angel to write his name in the list who love the fellow persons. This is a very important point, because Ben Adam's name is not in the list of the persons who loved the God. So Ben Adam requests to angel to write his name in the list who love his fellow person, who loves his neighbor, who loves the poor man, and who loves the needy person all around the world. And the angel wrote his name at the top of the list who loved God. This shows that if we love our fellow persons, the God also loves us. love gives us the same love. The poem is essentially spiritual with a universal message. This poem gives is a spiritual message which is called can be said a universal message because it has the universal appeal. Every society and every religion and every country shows his humbleness, his kindness to the other country, other religion and other type of people and country. So we should love to our fellow men, and we should love to our countrymen, we should love our neighbor, we should love to every person on this earth, and the God gives his love to us in the response. The technique of this poem. The poet uses similes, metaphors and a rhyme scheme in this poem. The rhyme scheme in this poem is AABB. Increase, peace, room, bloom, gold, bold, sad, had, accord, load, so, low. So we can say that it is a regular rhyme scheme. AABBCCDDEEFF. This is called a regular rhyme scheme, and there are couplets. There are many couplets in this poem, which is the same rhyme scheme. And the poet uses metaphors also in this poem to compare, and there are similes to compare the persons in this poem. There are two statements which was made by above Ben Adam. First is, what writest thou? What are you writing in your book? And the answer of the angel is that the names of those who love the Lord. Then again, Ben Adam asks, and is mine one? Is there my name is in the book? And he got the answer that, nay, not so. At that time, Abou Ben Adam not become demoralized, because he said that if there is not his name in this list, so please write my name in the list who loves his neighbor, who loves his fellow man. This is, shows the goodness of a heart, as we saw in the one act play, The Little Man, who loves the boy who has lost his mother. Although the little man knew that the boy has a disease of measles, which is very effective, which can affect to the little man also, but little man does not leave his goodness and kindness, and he protect the child, protect the boy, until his mother came there. So we can say, Abou Ben Adam is also a good personality, a good person or a good character in biblical, in Bible, and the Bible character gives us a moral message that we should love to our fellow persons. So, in these last three poems, we have read about everything, and in the next chapter, in the next class, we will read about Indian, English Indian poetry, which is related to what Tagore, Rabindranath Tagore, Kekian Daruwala, and Kabir. Where the Mind is Without Fear, a poem which is related to R.N. Tagore. Graft is a poem which is on the corruption, which is written by Kekian Daruwala, and The Master, which is written by Kabir. These are the poems we are going to read on the next class. Thanks.